The advent of technology and the internet has served as both a blessing and a curse to many businesses around the world. While many have been able to leverage on the internet to expand their businesses, a few are still lagging behind. One business, however, that has not been able to benefit from the internet is that of the sale of compact discs or CDs. The business, which existed in Ghana for over 50 years, is fast dwindling, with very little left of it. In Accra, the Opera Square serves as the hub for the distribution of CDs. Traders here tell me that the area, which used to accommodate at least 40 businesses in the early 2000s, now cannot even boast of 5. Desmond Osse, owner of Bresanti Film Shop in Accra, says business has dropped drastically compared to when he started some 15 years ago.
We usually, when we get a new movie, for instance, we can sell at least, say, 1,000 copies. Oh, within, let's say, 1 week or getting to 2 weeks. Yeah, okay. At least 1,000 movies. Yeah, but for now, no. For now, as to compare to this time, no. Even to sell, let's say, 100 movies, it's a problem. Internet, too, is also a problem, a major problem. The internet, yeah. Right now, they can download a movie. Let's say within a twinkle of an eye, they just get the copy. The moment they get the title, they comes out to find maybe the title, they get the title and then just download it. Yeah, and downloading is also bringing the business down.
For him, the right timing of films and series on local TV channels in Ghana might just be the solution to salvage what is left of the business.
Let's go today to our TV stations. Back in the days, we used to have movies like Esmeralda, Acapulco. And the time that they normally, you know, show this kind of movies was around, let's say, 9:30 p.m. 10 that way. But now, no, as to compare to this time, no. When they go to our movie and TV stations, we have movies that they do show around 2:30. 4:30, 5:30, 7:30. So assuming the person, let's say, a person maybe selling from the market, buys a movie, takes to the home, takes to the house or something like that to watch. He goes there and there's a movie showing. So with that, you know, he finds it in a way, say, okay, send me two movie. When I buy a movie and I take it home, let's say maybe my children, maybe they are watching maybe Kunkun Bagia, or maybe some other telenovela movies. So maybe buying that movie, our movies for now, no, I don't think maybe it's helpful for them, or maybe advice some way for them to buy. My plans towards the year to change the business. Yeah, if I have the capabilities to do that now, I'll do that.
Mohammed Nuruddin, on the other hand, who has been in the business for over 3 decades, says the quality of movies produced in the country is the reason for the slow pace of business. Though he started the business with the sale of locally produced content, he now sells only movies produced in Hollywood and Bollywood.
I'm into movies, Bollywood movies and Hollywood movies, but not Nollywood, not Gollywood. To me, I'm entitled to my opinion. They are not the best of the standard, because I know movie. I was born here in Accra Central, Opera Cinema. So if I see a quality movie, a good movie, I'll know one. And most of these Gollywood movies, they've been doing copyright from the American movies. Both the Bollywood and the Gollywood, they've been doing copyright for the American movies. But now, the customers are into Ghanaian movies and Nigerian movies. And the Ghanaian and Nigerian movies are not bringing the good ones out. So that's why, the sales has been dropping. But if they produce a good movie, why not? You know, if they produce a very good movie, good Nigerian movie or Ghanaian movie, people will patronize and people will come for the DVDs. So even if you look at my board, you see, it's Bollywood and a bit of American movies. Not even a single Gollywood or Nollywood. You look at the board. Not a single Gollywood or Bollywood. Because Bollywood, they want to be like Hollywood. Gollywood want to be like Hollywood. Why not Ghana films or Nigerian movies? Even in America, they're having problems. But almost on weekly basis, every first Monday or Tuesday, they do go rounds and check the sales. One movie can make like $100 million within 4 or 5 days. Why not here in Africa? If they want to be like the Hollywood, they are saying, right? But they are not. I don't know what you want to say. They have to maintain their own culture and then sell it to the people. But all of them want to be like the Americans. So how can you make it? Hollywood means everybody has got a very good taste. When they come, they see, they prefer the Hollywood movies than this Gollywood or Nollywood. It's just one way. Juju. Oh, too much juju. You know, in American movies, you don't see that much juju. You know, so they should try and then back up. And then they have to get the good education background before they go into the movie business. You can't just go to a course, 2 month course, I'm a producer, 1 month course, I'm a cameraman. That's all bogus. You know what I mean?
I caught up with some Ghanaians who shared with me their preference for purchasing CDs or otherwise.
Oh, I download. Yeah, I download from the internet. That's easy, fast. Yeah. You see, sometimes your area, there won't be any place to buy your CD. So you just get your internet, then you download easy, and that's all.
You need to look at certain things. We have something we call comparative advantage. Sometimes, before you, let me say, you purchase something, there can be alternatives that you can get it at lesser cost or no cost at all. It saves money. And time as well. And they looking at the portability of CD, carrying it along is another headache you have to look at.
I download. It's much easier, and sometimes when you go to the shops for the CDs, you don't get a particular movie you want to watch. So I prefer to download.
Yeah, I don't buy them, but I download them, and sometimes I get them from friends. Okay, I download them because it's easier, and that one, it doesn't cost much. But when I try buying them, it costs.
Business owners like Desmond say they will be compelled to divert from the sale of CDs to something more sustainable if immediate measures are not put in place. Reporting for City News, I am Anita Kisimuku.